USAG-KA held the first town hall of the year, giving an update on the COVID-19 protocol and marking Command Colonel Jeremy Bartell's second-to-last town hall here in the atoll. Bartell spoke about COVID and the changes that may be coming to the quarantine protocol and the estimated time of arrival for our non-mandatory vaccines on island. The current protocol begins at flying into Hawaii and going directly to the Halikoa Hotel. There, they will have their first COVID and antibody test on arrival, with a second test 48 hours before they fly. Here on Kwaj, we have adjusted our testing. The first test is on the 7th day of quarantine, and the second is on the 20th day of quarantine before being released. RMI have started to receive vaccines, and USAG-KA is looking at vaccines arriving in the spring. Due to our location, we will be receiving the Moderna vaccine because it can be stored easier than Pfizer. One change USAG-KA is attempting is reducing quarantine time here on island from 21 days to only 14. But this must be approved by the RMI before this change can be made. Some of the other topics brought up were water conditions and a few buildings on the south side that Environmental is already in the process of addressing. Some pet owners brought up concerns for their pets and conditions of the dog park, which USAG-KA will be looking into in the future. Residents asked about the optometrist and were informed where we were on that, potentially using a telemedicine service for renewals and changes to prescription. For more information, check out the recent hourglass coordinating to this episode's release.
It's that time of year again, when islanders head over to the clinic for their annual flu vaccine. One prick per islander keeps the influenza at bay, and ER nurse Lee Ann Stone makes the process as easy and painless as possible.
It's pretty quick. You come in, you sign in at the desk, we give you two forms that you have to fill out. You answer some health questions, give us authorization to treat you. You come in, we pick which arm, ask you, a couple, are you allergic to any medications? And then we stick you in the arm. It's literally seconds to get the injection done. The shot is quick and fairly painless. Well, if you're nervous about getting the flu shot, whether you're a kid or an adult, I can understand some people don't like shots at all. The big thing is we talk you through it. And my big thing that I like doing is just doing it really quick. If you have too much time to think about it, then you start getting yourself all worked up and anxious, and it's just quick. With the quarantine measures that the RMI has in place, we haven't had any, contagious or active COVID cases or flu cases, so we're doing really good.
So what was AFN Kwajalein's incentive to get the flu shot besides staying healthy?
We might get a sticker or lollipop or something like that if we have it around.
Islanders made their way to the country club on the south side of Kwaj to enjoy an evening of painting and sipping glasses of wine. Sip and paint allowed for a few hours to unwind and color a canvas, and each participant expressed their own individual style. An example painting was also provided to give unsure painters a starting point. As the bottles were emptied, the art became more and more detailed. As the evening wrapped up, artists found a stopping point and shared what they had created with one another. Of course, over one more glass of wine.
We've seen people take multiple sets of silverware, spoon, forks, knives, soup spoons. What happens is when we see that, we tell them you're not permitted to take the silverware. It's for dining in only. And so when that happens, I kind of go into detail explain there's significant cost to civil war. Not to mention the fact that supplies are difficult to get on the island. You know, we have a month to 2 month turnaround to replace things like that we're missing. When I first got here, I think we had maybe 12 forks in the whole facility, and it was about 6 coffee mugs when I first arrived. I mean, that's just how depleted it was, and so we're waiting a couple of months for supplies, and it takes a while, so. So the server will ask them to speak with the manager if they want additional food, and once that happens, they speak to myself or a supervisor, and the supervisor explains to them their proper portion allotment, and explains to them that if they want more, then they're more than welcome to purchase another meal. What we define excess food is, for example, your plate. If you come in and you decide, I just want to eat one thing, and you load that plate up with strawberries and nothing else, you've exceeded your portion allotment for that particular entree. A meal is designed for you to get full off all the courses, meat, starch, vegetables, your dessert, your salad, and your pastry. So you can't come in and just fill up off of one entree. The meal is not designed for that. The Army regulations is not designed that way. In terms of us staying in budget, we do have budget restraints. And so for us to stay within those budget restraints, you have to consume all parts of the meal to get full, not just off of meat. You require one meal per person, which is written out in accordance with USAG-KA, posted on the serving line. It's one meat, one starch, one vegetable. An extra portion of vegetables if you're per your request. Anything beyond that is considered double dipping, and that's against Army policy. Well, we'll approach that individual and we'll explain to them they're not permitted to bring outside containers in for food. The only containers they're allowed to use to pack food in is the containers we provide, which is the clamshell. We have a large clamshell and a small clamshell. Smaller clamshell for salads, desserts, larger clamshell for meat, starch, vegetables, and breads. So.
What are you doing here?
I must see you.
Pitiful canine. My heart has moved on from you. Stay on the lawn where your kind belongs.
This is a bachelor's quarters, no? You left me, so I'm a bachelor now, no?
You are no bachelor. Just a hopeless romantic canine who chases the lizards and pants loudly.
My love chases you. My love pants for you.
Your kind is forbidden here. It is the law of the land. It is the law of my heart.
I do not entertain such silly laws. Let me in.
No.
Let me in.
Pathetic canine.
Let me in.